Welcome students for today's lecture. So today's topic is DC and AC circuits. So in our previous lecture we saw some numerical problems based on Ohm's law and then Kirchhoff's law, that is Kirchhoff's voltage law and Kirchhoff's current law. So now we're going to see what is AC circuit and what is DC circuit and what is the difference between both. Okay, so before going to DC or AC circuit, first what is an electrical circuit? So an electrical circuit is nothing but a closed path. So it should be a closed path, and it should be complete, and there must be any circulating current that should be flow in that closed path. That is called circuit. So it is a just complete and closed path around which an electric current can flow. So let us say, take this as an example. So here we have a battery. So from the battery to switch, from switch to bulb, and from bulb to again battery. So we use wire to connect these three components. So this is a closed path because the connection is started from positive terminal of battery and it entered to the negative terminal of battery. So it will form a closed path, and when you switch on the the current will flow from battery to bulb, and which will make the bulb glow. So here the circuit gets completed. Okay, so if you take any electric circuit, the common parts are power source. So here we are used for battery. If a power source, it can be a battery or it can be generator or even it can be a solar panel. Okay, so next one, conductor. So conductor is nothing but here we are using wire. So wire just conducts the current and it carry the conduct from one point to another point. Okay, and then load. So here we have used the lamp load. It may be a fan or it may be a motor or air conditioner or anything. Okay, so basically any circuit, it needs a power source, a load, and then a conductor. Switch is optional. So here we have used switch to control the on and off of the circuit. Okay, so here our battery or power source, this supplies electrical energy to load. Okay, so here the load is light bulb. So here electrical energy was converted into light energy. Okay, similarly if you are using a motor, here means the electrical energy is converted to mechanical energy. So by using an electrical circuit, we are converting one form of energy, that is electrical energy, into another form of energy based on our application. So now go for DC circuit. So DC circuit is nothing but any circuit in which the power source have a direct current facility. Okay, so that is, the power source should be a DC power source. So first of all, what is DC? DC is nothing but direct current. This here, source of power will be any battery or DC generator or solar PV. So that is a power source which gives DC power. So how can you say a power is a DC power? Okay, so it should supply a constant voltage. If it's a pure DC power source, then it should supply a constant voltage throughout the time. Okay, it is independent of time. For example, if I am drawing a power from a battery, throughout the time the output voltage should be 12 volt. So it should not vary from 0, 12 or 10, 9 or minus 12 like that. Okay, it should be constant and it should be independent of time. That's the one thing. And another point, the flow of current should be in only one direction. So we say that as a unidirectional. So unidirectional means flow is only in one direction. So here in the circuit, the flow is from positive terminal of battery. So here to switch, from switch to lamp, lamp to again battery. So it is in clockwise direction. So if you want anti-clockwise direction, then you have to just interchange the battery terminals. Okay, so without that you can't make the current directional into anti-clockwise. So even though that time, you can simply say it will again flow from positive terminal to bulb, from that to switch, from that to negative terminal. So anyhow, the current will only flow in one direction when your battery was connected to the load. Okay, so here we mostly use resistor to oppose the current. Okay, in DC circuits, so we have passive elements, right? Resistors, inductors and capacitors. So in that, only resistor will play the role of opposing current in DC circuit. But in case of AC circuit, so all, that is resistor, inductor, capacitor, all the three will play the role to oppose the current. Okay, so these are the waveforms. So here the first one, this is a pure DC waveform. So you can see throughout the time the voltage or current value is always constant, and see the current value is only positive. So that is not a negative current here. So simply we can say this is a constant voltage and unidirectional current. So it is only flowing in positive direction. Similarly, this is impure DC, because here current is positive, but the value is not a constant value. So there was some ripple. What you say as a ripple is just as there is a increase in the desired level. If I need a 5 volt, means it just increases to 5.1, 5.2 to 6 volt at some point. Okay, this is called as impure DC, and this is called as pulse DC. So here the supply will be given at certain time. So it will be off condition for some time, and it will be in on condition supplying the full voltage. So it's like switch. So whenever your DC is zero, we will consider that as a off position, and whenever it is in maximum voltage, it should be considered as an on position. Okay, so impure DC can be converted to pure DC by using some filters. Okay, as of now we don't want to go there. So just to see what is DC circuit and what are the waveforms and all. Okay, so next the simples. Okay, so in case of voltage source, so for battery we will use this type of symbol with the long terminal at the top and small terminal at the bottom. So here's the small terminal will denote the negative terminal, and long terminal, the long line, that will represent your positive terminal. So if you want to represent a multiple connection of cell, okay, there is more than 2-3 cells, that is battery. So battery is mainly a connection of more than 6 or 12 cells based on its operating voltage, right? In that time we will use this symbol. In a normal DC voltage source, we will represent a normal circle. Inside that we will put the polarity, or we will put the symbol V, and in the terminals we will just know that what is positive and what is negative terminal. You can simply put a circle, and inside the circle you can simply represent positive and negative. That can be considered as a DC voltage source. Similarly for current, so this is a symbol. Okay, any single circle with arrow or double circle with arrow. So mainly this will represent the DC current source, and this is same for your AC current source. So AC current source also the same symbol will be followed. Okay, here the arrow mark represents the direction of your current. So current is moving from this point to this point. So if the direction is downward, then current will move from top to bottom. Okay, so here the current is moving from bottom to top. So, and these are the symbols for your resistor. So first one is a fixed value resistor, that is the resistor value won't change throughout the time. Okay, again this is mainly based on IEC. Okay, there are some different standards available. So this is mainly based on IEC symbol. And next one is also just to represent a fixed value resistor, but this is based on IEEE. Okay, next one is a potentiometer. Here we have a hard lug, so based on that we can vary the resistor. Okay, this is called as variable resistor, and this one is a rheostat similar to potentiometer. So this is a light dependent resistor. So based on the light value, the resistor value will be varied. These are the things we will use in the DC circuits. So now this is a normal circuit with a voltage source and a resistive load. Here the current through the load is nothing but I is equal to VR, that is by Ohm's law. So if you draw the graph with respect to time and current, then your current will be constant and unidirectional like shown in this figure. Okay, so that is V by R is constant throughout the time. So whatever may be the time, it will be constant. So when you just give the power supply at zero, so it will be maximum, that is V by R. Even after 2 or 3 seconds also, the value will be constant. With the same circuit, if I am just connecting a voltmeter to measure the voltage and ammeter to measure the current through the load, and if I want to draw a graph with respect to your voltage and current, so this is a graph drawn with respect to your voltage and current, then will give a relation between the voltage and current. That is, as per Ohm's law, V is equal to IR, then R is equal to V by I. So this will give the relationship between your V and I. So it is nothing but a straight line. So it started at zero, and for V is equal to 1, then I also will be equal to 1. Similarly, V is equal to I also equal to 2. So if you just plot the points at each point, then it will just give a straight line with a 45 degree of angle from the origin. Okay, so this is what we called as linear elements or linear circuit relationship. So in DC circuits, for resistive load, relation will be always linear. So now coming to AC circuit. So it is similar to the definition of DC circuit. So instead of DC power source, here we are using an alternating source. That is, the value of your voltage and current will vary throughout the time. So in DC circuits, the voltage and current will be constant, but here it will get varied. So for that, we will use the symbol like this. So this is a AC voltage source symbol. Okay, here the title just mentioning it is an alternating sinusoidal waveform. That is, it is representing a sine waveform. So here the voltage is not constant throughout the time, and similarly your current also not constant, and your current will flow in two directions. That is, either it flows in clockwise direction and anti-clockwise direction. That's why in this symbol we have given that current is flowing towards this side and towards this side. Okay, so both direction will be possible without changing any terminal of the source. So here main source of power is generator, that is alternator or AC generator. Okay, so here the magnitude of voltage and current are non-constant, and it will change with respect to time. And similarly, your current is bidirectional, that is, it will flow in clockwise and anti-clockwise direction. So here, unlike DC circuits where just resistor will be used to oppose the current, here all three passive elements, that is resistor, inductor and capacitor, so all three will oppose the current. Okay, so if you compare the AC and DC circuit, so AC circuit has some advantages over DC. So first one, here the voltage in AC system can be raised or lowered. So if I'm just generating a 100 volt AC, it can be either increased by using step-up transformer to some 11 kV like that, or even some 11 kV voltage can be stepped down to 230 volt by using step-down transformer. So with the help of transformer, either the voltage can be raised or lowered. Next one, by increasing the voltage to a higher level, we can transmit the AC power for long distance electrical transmission without loss, because mainly loss is due to the resistor, that is I square R. So by increasing the voltage to a higher level, we are decreasing the current, thereby we are decreasing the losses. And third one, so construction is and cost of AC generators are low compared to your DC generators. And then mostly we are using electrical motors, so which need a supply as AC supply. Compared to DC electrical motor, AC electrical motors are cheaper, but it requires very less maintenance compared to DC. And again, so AC can be converted into DC by using rectifier. Similarly, DC also can be converted to AC by using inverter. These are the advantages of AC over DC. Similarly, DC also has some advantages over AC. So these are the different alternating current waveform. So the first one is a sinusoidal waveform. Here, the waveform will follow the sine value. So at 0 degree, the answer, the value will be 0. So at 90 degree, the value will be 1. So at 180, again 0. So it will follow the values of sine theta. Okay, sine 0, sine 1, 2, until sine 360. If you just get the points and plot, you will get this waveform. So it will follow the sine waveform. So next one is a triangular waveform. Okay, and this is a square waveform, and this is a complex waveform. This is just a distortion that was made in sine waveform. So these are the available AC waveforms. Even though we have lot of AC waveforms available, so preferably we are going for sine wave because of its merits compared to other
AC waveforms. Okay, so in the electrical side, mostly we are using sine wave as an alternating quantity.
If possible, just find why we are using sinusoidal waveform as a standard AC waveform instead of going for triangular or square wave. So that is a that as an assignment. If possible, find a hint can be given. It is mainly based on BH curve. So you have studied, right? So BH curve. So based on that only, we have chosen sinusoidal waveform as a best waveform for alternating quantity. So this is a normal connection where we have made a alternating voltage source here and a resistive load here. And this is a waveform, a voltage waveform. So here from 0 to pi, that is 0 to 180 degree, the voltage value is positive. Okay, so that we call it as a positive half cycle. Similarly, from 180 to 360 degree, that is pi to 2 pi, we have negative voltage source, that is called as negative off cycle. So during positive off cycle, the current will travel from this terminal to load and again it will just end up here. Okay, so instead of positive negative, for AC we will tell this as a phase. So phase at this point and neutral at this point. So instead of negative, we will tell that as a neutral. Similarly, for negative off, so negative off, what will happen is, so this terminal will become negative, that is neutral, and this terminal will become phase, that is positive. So again the current will flow from here to load, from that to again neutral. So for a single cycle, that is from 0 to 360 degree, so we have two direction of current. So one is towards clockwise and another is towards anti-clockwise. That's why we are telling this is a bidirectional current flow or bidirectional voltage flow. Okay, so this is a current waveform, sorry, voltage waveform, and this is a current waveform. So we will, in the next slide, we will really see what is IM and what is cycle, what is time period and all. So why we are going for sinusoidal, so that is taken or that is given as a assignment. So for your side, so mostly commercially the alternators we have, that is generators we have, is producing sinusoidal waveform as an output. Okay, that's the one thing. And another one, so how we are producing the sinusoidal waveform, that is AC waveform, by using the generator. So how generator works? So generators mainly work based on the principle of Faraday's law. Okay, so whenever in a magnetic field, if you are rotating a conductor, then the conductor will experience a EMF. When the conductor was a closed circuit, then there will be some current which will just flow through the conductor. So that is a basic principle of your generator. From the generator we are producing the sinusoidal waveform. Okay, so if the amplitude is taken from across the conductor, then it will be considered as a voltage, and if it is taken in the series of the conductor, then it will be considered as a your current. So we have two quantities. First one is a EMF and second one is a current. So in a closed circuit, there will be a flow of current, but voltage will be there even there is a no closed circuit. So the sinusoidal, how can we express the voltage in terms of sine? So here Em is the maximum value. Okay, that is a peak point. So if you draw the graph, you can simply say this is the maximum point. So here the sine waveform is nothing but the value is from 0 to 1 and again 1 to 0, then 0 to minus 1, then minus 1 to 0. So we are just multiplying the maximum voltage with sine waveform. So the equation can be written as V is equal to Vm sine omega t. Omega t are sine theta. Okay, so here I have in x-axis we have mentioned omega t. So for that we have mentioned here also omega t. So for example, if Vm is nothing but here the maximum voltage of the generator, okay, and then small v is nothing but the voltage at any point, that is instantaneous voltage. If I want the voltage is 0, then substitute omega t is equal to 0. So sine 0 is nothing but 0, the value is 0. Okay, similarly, if I want the value of pi by 2, so what is the value of voltage at pi by 2? Substitute here pi by 2, sine pi by 2 is nothing but 1. So 1 into Vm, the answer will be Vm. So here Vm. So similarly, you can substitute if you want at any point. So just substitute the value here, then you can find the value of that voltage. So instantaneous voltage is nothing but voltage at any point taken at time. Okay, similarly for current, we can write the equation as I is equal to, small I is equal to Im. So Im is nothing but maximum current value into sin omega t. Okay. So now we can represent the AC voltage in terms of graph, and we will see the what are the terminologies we will use in AC waveforms. So the first one is instantaneous value or instantaneous voltage. So it is nothing but at any instant, if you take the value of the waveform, either it is a current or voltage, that will be called as an instantaneous value. Cycle is nothing but a complete sum of your positive off and then negative off. Okay. So this will be called as a cycle. So here, from 0 to 2 pi is considered as a cycle. So cycle is nothing but there should be some waveform or some shape that should be repeated. So if you take a sine waveform, so here the waveform symbol, so this will get repeated throughout the cycle. Okay, so this is not a pure sine waveform because of my handwriting not getting like pure, but this shape, so from here to here, so this is repeating throughout the cycle. So what is the shape that is repeating we consider as a cycle. So even you can take this one. So if you take this waveform, so here we have only positive wave. So even though the shape which is repeating is here, so from this point to this point, what is the shape is that is repeating throughout the cycle, then here this will be considered as one cycle. Okay, so this is second cycle, third cycle and fourth cycle. So cycle is nothing but whether in terms of AC it is just a complete set of positive and negative values, but in terms of any waveform, just the any shape that is repeating throughout the cycle is called as a cycle. Next one, time period. So time period is nothing but the time taken to complete a one cycle, that is here the time taken to complete from 0 to 2 pi, so that is called as time period. So we will represent that as a capital T. So similarly, frequency. So frequency is nothing but number of cycles, that is here one cycle is 0 to 2 pi, like this number of cycles that was generated for 1 second. Okay, for 1 second, so how many number of cycles that was generated by the source, that is called as frequency, which is measured either in hertz or cycle per second. Okay, so frequency is mainly used for alternating quantity. Okay, it won't be used for DC. Mostly we won't mention frequency for DC waveform. For DC waveform there is no alternating quantity unless using the pulse waveform. For a pure DC, we saw a waveform, right? So it's a just a constant straight line. So in the constant straight line, we don't have any repeating cycle or repeating waveform, right? So for that, we will tell the frequency as zero. For DC, the frequency is zero. For alternating quantity in India, so in India we have a standard frequency of 50 hertz. Okay, so that is we are getting power supply from our grid, right? So throughout the grid we are using the frequency as 50 hertz, and for a single phase supply we are using up to 230 volt RMS. So next one, amplitude. So amplitude is nothing but the maximum value, or that is a peak value, either it is a positive one like this Vm or negative one like this minus Vm. So the Vm is called as your amplitude, which is nothing but the maximum value of your waveform. Next one, phase. So phase is nothing but the angular difference between zero and the starting point of your alternating quantity. For example, here we have two waveforms, so just consider a single waveform. So just consider I, okay, that is the dotted waveform. So then the angular difference between zero and A is called as phase. Okay, if you compare the phase of two alternating quantities, that is here we have a waveform V, two sine waveform, and I also a few sine form, but mentioned in dotted, right? Okay. So if you compare the phase difference, between B and I, then we tell that as a phase difference. So here the pi is nothing but phase difference between voltage V and current I. So from the waveform we can relate some of the points. So first one is time period T can be mentioned as 1 by F, that is reciprocal of your frequency, because for time period, what is the definition? The time taken for one cycle. So frequency is nothing but number of cycles per second. Okay, so based on that we can just derive, so time period is nothing but reciprocal of frequency. Similarly, we can say frequency is nothing but reciprocal of your
time period. Okay, so if you want just to get the definition, time period is nothing but the time taken for one cycle. Okay, so frequency is nothing but number of cycles per second. So per second means we have time. So if I want in terms of 1 second means you have to bring the number of cycles to the denominator. So from that we are just getting the time period is equal to 1 by f. Okay. And next one, angular velocity. So angular velocity is nothing but the rotation made by the generator. Okay. So where the overall angle turn will be 360 degrees. So it will make a circular rotation. So the overall angle is 2 pi, that is 360, and time taken is considered capital T. So this will be called as your angular velocity. That is nothing but your speed is equal to distance by time, right? So based on that, so here distance 2 pi and time is just a T. So since we are talking about angle, it is considered an angular velocity. So 1 by T is nothing but your frequency. So this can be considered 2 pi f, that is my f. So angular velocity is nothing but 2 pi into frequency. So these are the relation which should be helpful in solving AC circuits. So next one, so here we gonna see the AC circuit with different load, that is R load, L load and C load. So we are not going in detail with these circuits. So we are just seeing about what is the relationship between voltage and current with respect to load. Okay, so how it is opposing and what is the waveform for the voltage and current for the given load. So if you take for R load, it should follow the Ohm's law. As per Ohm's law, so IR is equal to V by T. So V is nothing but your input voltage source. So I is our input current, so which will flow to the load. So based on that, we can just simply measure VR is nothing but I of T, that is current from the source into your load. Okay. So here, so whenever your source current started increasing from 0 to maximum, in the time there will be a voltage drop across resistor, which will also start up from 0 to maximum point. So current will also do the same. So current will also follow the same circuit as of your voltage. So if you draw the waveform, that is output waveform for your voltage VR and current through the resistor IR, then this will be the graph. So both are sinusoidal and you can see the phase difference. So in the previous slide I told, right? So if you saw the, if you take the difference between the two waveform from 0 point, then you can tell the angle as a phase. So here both current and voltage starting from 0. So here there is a no phase difference. So phase difference is equal to 0. So for that, what we will say is, we will say both are in phase. So they are starting at same 0 degree. So this is called as in phase. Okay. Similarly, if you are going for a circuit with the inductive load, so here the resistive load is right, so that is mainly to oppose current. Similarly, inductor also used to oppose current. Okay, but we won't mention that in terms of pure inductance. So for that we will use a term called reactance. So reactance is nothing but representing inductance in terms of ohms. So resistance is nothing but just a capacity to oppose the current, right? Similarly, inductor has the capacity to oppose the current, but we are just representing that as a ohm. So for that we will use the formula as XL. The XL is nothing but inductive reactance, so which is equal to 2 pi f into L, because here the f, that is nothing but your frequency of your input waveform. So based on your frequency, the reactance will vary. Okay, that's why we have used 2 pi f L. So 2 pi f is nothing but your angular velocity. So XL can be considered as omega L. So in case of relation between current and voltage, so current can be driven by voltage divided by opposition to current flow. So that is as usual as your Ohm's law. So I is equal to V by R. So here R we are representing in terms of XL. So V is equal to omega L. Similarly, if you plot a output waveform for voltage and current, so this will be your output voltage and this one will be your output current. So here you can see there is a phase difference, right? So because your voltage waveform has a peak at 0, but at the same time your current has 0 at 0. The value of current is 0 at the angle 0. Similarly, your voltage have maximum point at 0. So simply we can say there is a phase angle difference of 90 dB. So here your voltage is zero, but at the same time the current is zero here. So if you take this angle, so it will be equal to 90. So here we can simply say your voltage is leading the current. Okay, so IL is lagging VL, or VL is leading current by 90 degree if you are using inductive load. And similarly, inductive reactance is nothing but XL is equal to 2 pi f L. Okay, so in terms of DC, so for DC I told right, the frequency is 0. If you substitute 0 here, then XL equal to 0. So XL equal to 0 means there is no resistance at all. If there is no resistance, then your inductance will act as a short circuit. So this is the reason why we didn't use inductance in DC circuit. Similarly, if you have a maximum frequency, that is, for example, frequency is taken as infinity, okay, then 2 pi into infinity into L, which will be again equal to infinity. So if the resistance is infinity, then the circuit, the inductance will act as an open circuit. It won't allow any current to pass through that. So for frequency equal to infinity, inductance will act as an open circuit. For frequency equal to 0, the inductance will act as a short circuit. So similarly, if you go for a capacity load, the same as visual of your inductive light. So here the capacity reactance in terms of ohms again represented by 1 by 2 pi fc, so which is equal to 1 by omega c. So if you want the relationship between the current and voltage, so I is equal to V by fc, similar to V by R. So instead of R, we are just using the capacity reactance in ohms. Okay, similarly, if you draw a graph between your output voltage and output current, similarly here also there is a 90 degree phase difference, but here your current is leading and your voltage is lagging. So voltage is starting at 0, okay, from this point, but at the same time your current is getting to 90 degree. So if you draw the phase relationship between your output voltage and current, then your current IC is leading the voltage VC by 90 degree, or simply DC is lagging IC by 90 degree. So here also, if you want to substitute the frequency, okay, DC FC equal to 0. If you substitute FC equal to 0 here, this will be infinity. For infinity resistance, the circuit will act as an open circuit. That is, capacitor will act as an open circuit. For FC equal to infinity, that is 1 by infinity is nothing but 0. Okay. For that, it will act as a short circuit. So inductor for FC equal to 0 act as a short circuit, but capacitor will act as an open circuit. Similarly, for FC equal to infinity, capacitance will act as short circuit, but inductor will act as a open circuit. So these are the very basic that I want to tell in the topic AC circuit. So because in the fourth unit we will detailly study about transient analysis of R load, RL load, RC load, RLC load, like that. For that, this will be the basic. So in this lecture we saw what is DC circuit and what is AC circuit, and the phasor diagram and relationship between your voltage and output current for R load, L load and C load. Okay, kindly go through the video. If possible, if you have any query or if you have any feedback on the video, just kindly let me know either through the WhatsApp group or just ping me the same. Okay, and complete the MCQ posted in our Moodle classroom. Thank you guys.